What's up, everybody? Tom Pelissero here with Judd Zulgad. Judd, 8 days ago, that was our last video.
Yes.
I thought that this year coaching changes might occur a little more quickly. They did make a significant move promoting Rick Spielman to general manager, but yet again, we're 2 weeks after the season finale, and we're still waiting for coaching changes. You have Fred Pagac in the building at a time they're interviewing potential replacements.
Right.
It's awkward. I understand the thinking behind it because perhaps they want to keep him on staff in another capacity. But it's still strange. It doesn't augur quite right.
It wouldn't be as awkward if it were just this year with Pagac. But you remember last year, Daryl Bevel, the offensive coordinator, sat there while Josh McDaniels came in, for instance. And then Brian Murphy, special teams coordinator, he sat there and while guys came in. And so there's this precedent now with the Vikings that they've got guys interviewing for people's jobs while those people are still on staff. If it was just Pagac and our theory was they wanted to move him back to linebackers coach, for instance, I'd say, okay, I get that. But this 2 years running now of having guys sitting there while other guys come in to interview for their jobs. And on top of that, what do we always talk about Les Frazier? Great guy. You know, people love him. This one is just odd. It's just odd to me to have people coming in talking to the head coach about a job that somebody currently holds. And they're sitting in their office saying, I wonder what I should do next.
Well, the one thing that I think that there is a connection here is the fact that I think they would like Pagac to return as a linebackers coach because he is an excellent linebackers coach. And those guys like him a lot. Perhaps unlike their last year's linebackers coach, Mike Singletary, who
right.
I don't know what capacity he's going to be in. They're going to interview Singletary for the job. I don't buy for a second that he has any chance of being named the defensive coordinator just because I think there's too many red flags he already raised in 1 year and the fact that he's never done it. He's never coordinated an NFL defense.
We've heard nothing but negatives about Mike Singletary and his coaching. My only theory on this one is Les Frazier and Mike Singletary are very good friends. Obviously, Frazier probably would like to remain friends with this guy, so maybe he gives him an interview. Mike doesn't get the job, and then Mike sort of gets the hint. Because that's the only reason I could see, after all we heard about Singletary this year, there's no other good reason I can see why you would run this guy through for a potential promotion, when, if anything, what we've both been told is he needs to go.
Except at the same time, I think it was probably about a month and a half ago, we were both hearing that maybe Singletary was the plan to be the new defensive coordinator, and that maybe that plan even dated back to when they hired him. Let's not forget, guys had contracts. The assistant coaches had contracts. Fred Pagac was going to be around into this season. Did they end up in a situation where Frazier basically told Singletary, listen, if you come in, do this for a year. If things don't work out with Pagac, I'll give you the job. Because I heard from people who were convinced Singletary was going to be the guy, and that wasn't that long ago. Maybe the red flags all cropped up and people
right.
started being more clear with their feelings down the stretch of the season.
Right.
But you continued to hear that later on. I wonder if there was a change at some point.
There definitely was. The only question was, and this is hard to know, is when do people start to speak up? Because you don't know. I would imagine that early on, if Singletary was as ineffective as we heard he was, somebody had to go in early in the season and say, you know, Fred Pagac did a really good job as linebackers coach. This guy, we don't know what he's doing. So the whole situation's pretty interesting. When Singletary got hired, I think we both said this. He's the assistant head coach. He's one of Frazier's best friends. He's going to be the defensive coordinator in 2012.
Right.
We all said that. But somewhere along the line, something changed, and I don't think it's as sudden as we think it was. I think something had, early in the season, had to be said, because this sounds like, as ineffective as things were for this defense this year, Carl Dunbar's gone, but he had a good defensive line. Joe Woods...
There were red flags on Carl Dunbar as well.
But Joe Woods, the defensive backs coach, I've also heard some good stuff about. Singletary's the only guy that I can't find anybody to
right.
come out and say, this guy was a good coach. And Dunbar, that's a weird story too. He's telling people with 3 weeks left in the season, I'm gone, I'm leaving. And then he's the first guy to be quote-unquote fired, and we really don't know what happened there.
Right, and then you've got the other names that have been connected to the potential of the defensive coordinator position. Steve Spagnuolo, I still think, and I know there was one report already that he's going to end up back in Philly. I would think he's going to end up back in the NFC East. This would be, I would think, a good situation, maybe not for him, but for the Vikings, to bring in a guy who's done it before. They wouldn't have to make a significant overhaul in their front. They would play with a completely different mentality, that blitz-heavy type of a scheme that he's used in the past.
The red flag with Spagnuolo coming to the Vikings, in my mind, is he is really, really good friends with Brad Childress.
Yeah.
Brad Childress was fired here. He might like Les Frazier, but Spagnuolo is friends with Andy Reid and Brad Childress. Philadelphia, you got to think, is going to do something defensively, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it makes sense he goes back there. He becomes the coordinator. Remember, he was a position coach there and then became a coordinator of the Giants. So it makes far more sense in my mind for him to go back to Philadelphia. And what wouldn't make sense is if he's really as tight with Childress as we think he is, coming here would be a bit, I think, of an odd situation.
Things could change with Raheem Morris, but it doesn't sound as though that's going to happen. We're 5 days after he came in for an interview. I think it also could be a tough sell if you're saying we're going to get rid of Fred Pagac, who led the number 21 defense in the NFL,
right,
to go to a guy who led the number 30 defense in the NFL and did not, even though he has a Tampa 2 background, didn't use all Tampa 2, didn't even use mostly Tampa 2 last year. A lot of cover 2 shell, a lot of man cover 1, even some 3-4 stuff in the front.
Think about, though, the toughest thing in this whole situation is this. Leslie Frazier is signed to a 3-year contract. Year 1 is up. We think year 3 might be an option of some sort. How do you bring a big-name defensive coordinator here for one season and say, you might get blown out? There's not a ton of security in coaching, but ordinarily if you go in as an assistant coach, you get a multi-year contract, you know the head coach is going to be there for a couple years. Leslie Frazier can't guarantee any prospective candidate that he's going to be there past 2012. And even if Rick Spielman says, I will be here, that's not your coach.
No.
You're not on his staff.
And even for a guy like Raheem Morris, you don't want to be in a situation where you get fired twice in 1 year. And that's kind of the challenge here. And then you also wonder what sort of a contract do they get. It's been standard that they get 2-year contracts for all the assistants, right? But how much security does that really provide you? And you just have to ask those questions.
And the other thing about the security, too, is most of these coaches from the Vikings got 2-year contracts before this season. So the first year is up. Now, what we don't know is, are they going to get a rollover contract, or are they all going to be working on 1-year contracts? There is a potential that Frazier is going to be in some type of option year, and every assistant coach is going to be in the last year of his deal. It is a recipe for blowing this thing up after the 2012 season. There is no security.
It's one more reason that some of these guys might still be on staff, because if they're not going to want to bring in, it's going to be tough to sign new assistants to 1-year deals. But if you've got guys going to the final year of their deal, maybe you go, you know what? We'll just let you, Joe Woods, you're sticking around for a little longer. Although you would think any new defensive coordinator would want to bring in his guys. Mel Tucker has to be the guy that they are looking at this point, doesn't he?
He was
in town earlier this week, if Jacksonville doesn't lock him up.
I would think so, and you do have to wonder if Mel Tucker interests Rick Spielman in the sense that he's worked with the 4-3 and the 3-4, and I know you've said that Raheem Morris did some 3-4 work before.
But not to that extent.
But Tucker has a lot of knowledge in both systems. If you're talking about, let's say under Leslie Frazier in 2012, they play a 4-3. Tucker could be the ideal guy to keep around, though, because then if you transition in 2013 to a 3-4, he could do it. So you could potentially sign him to a 2-year contract, hire a new head coach in 2013, and say, Mel Tucker's your guy, and it could work.
A lot up in the air, and if you're looking at this from Leslie Frazier's perspective, a very important hire, whatever he ends up doing with the defense going forward here. Then they go down to the Senior Bowl. They've got access to all those guys, both on the practice field as well as in meetings. Mm-hmm. Then you're going into the real, you're also right now in the thick of the due diligence process on all the underclassmen you weren't allowed to have contact with during the season. So that's all leading up toward the combine. They're going through personnel meetings this week. It's really a big few months here.
It's
Rick
huge.
Spielman, you've just been given the GM job. We assume you've been given a new contract, even though we don't know the terms of that contract. If you're Rick Spielman, you can look at this in a global view, and you can look at this as a 3-year plan. If you're Leslie Frazier, you know you have to show a significant step forward this season if you want to still be the guy.
But don't you think for Frazier, at least the parameters now, and I know he was demoted, really, because he lost personnel, say, but the parameters are very clear now for him. Rick Spielman now can come in. Rick has always wanted to do this. He always had his theories and his charts and his graphs, and they're nuts sometimes. But he could only go halfway there. He could only go halfway. Now he can go all out and say, this is what we're doing. So if you're Leslie Frazier and you're holding meetings now and talking to coaches, the parameters of your job are really, really, really clear. Spielman's the guy to me that's got some pressure now, because now it's on him. Now he's the personnel guy. He's the guy that if his rating system doesn't work, if things don't work, it's going to be on him. So
But the proof will not be in the pudding this year.
No, and he's not going to get fired after this year. But my point is, now you know how things work at Winter Park. And for you and me, we know who to blame.
I think we're going to have answers on what's going to happen with the coaching staff in the next 10 days or so here. And, of course, we'll be updating everything at 15RESPN.com. He's Judd. I'm Tom. See you.